everybody to our rescheduled City Planning Commission meeting. Today is Tuesday, April 9th, 2019. It's 5:18 p.m. I call this meeting to order. In attendance, we have Alan Keelan, Eric Olson, Tracy Barrett, Justin Behrens, Mayor Brian Smith, Henry Velliker, and Brennan Kane for staff. You have a agenda in front of you. I don't think there's any additions or deletions to that. We'd need a motion to approve that agenda then.
Move to approve.
Second.
Motion by Eric, second by Alan, that we approve the agenda as printed. Discussion, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Against, motion carried. We have Planning Commission minutes from March 6th for the public hearing, and then also the regular minutes of the March 6th meeting. We would need a motion to approve those and place those on file.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Tracy, second by Eric, that we approve the Planning Commission minutes from March meetings. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Against, motion carried. Under action items, we have a certified survey map for Ken Dujinsky and South Industrial Drive. And Brennan, you're?
Yep, thank you, Mayor, members of the Planning Commission. This is a city initiated certified survey map within our business and technology park. Staff is working with the applicant, Ken Dujinsky, on the construction of a 10,600 plus or minus square foot building for his wood renovators. We'll be looking at the site plan next. Ken has requested this proposed location, which is just south of the Grex Pool, or which will be the former Grex Pool. They are vacating that facility. Several years ago, the city did do, this used to be one parcel. We did do a land division several years ago for a previously approved project, which was the Alliance Industries development, and this was the northern parcel. We are looking to redivide the northern parcel into two lots. Ken is seeking about 3 acres, so we are splitting the existing parcel into two. He is looking to construct his building on the north parcel of the proposed CSM. This was a draft CSM as we are working through the site plan and the future developers agreement that needs to be approved by the Common Council at a future meeting. But if recommended by the Planning Commission to the Common Council, it will become an official map. We will have Mark go back out there. We still had a lot of snow out there when he was looking to do the CSM, so the pins do need to be placed in the ground yet. But again, Ken is looking to develop on lot one of the proposed CSM in front of you.
So it's quite simple. We're just recommending to council that the actual certified survey map.
That is correct.
Lot one.
Yep. Well, it would be, it's both a two-lot. It's a two-lot CSM, correct?
Okay. All right. Just to accommodate.
Correct. Lot one will be sold to Ken. Lot two will be, remain in the ownership of the city.
Okay. Anybody have any questions? Motion?
Move to approve.
A second.
Motion by Alan, second by Tracy, that we approve of the CSM for lot one and two on South Industrial Drive. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Against? Motion carried. And now the site plan review.
Yep. Thank you, Mayor, members of the Planning Commission. In your packet is a site plan application request for Ken Dujinsky's wood renovators business. Ken was located within the city at one time and then did actually relocate during the downturn to a couple different facilities outside of the city, and he's actually coming back to the city to consolidate a couple different places that he currently rents outside of the city and is looking to construct a new building and office on within our industrial park. The proposed building that he is seeking is a 10,000 square foot renovation warehouse area, along with about a 625 square foot office building on the front. The property is currently zoned I-2, which is heavy industrial, and this use it does conform to the existing zoning that's out there and does not need a special use permit. The site plan was reviewed. We have been working with Ken and then Wayne Muck, who is his agent that is here this evening, if there are any questions on it. We have, from a site plan perspective, it conforms. It just needs to, a couple updating. There are a couple things that we are compromising and working with the applicant on. The business park typically does require brick on all four sides of the building. The applicant, because of possible expansion in the future, has requested to concentrate more of that decorative material on the front office space in the front of the building, as well as a majority of the site is going to be a paved parking lot and drive lane area. However, the property that, or any space west of the building or behind where the loading dock is going to be, the applicant has requested that be a gravel material at this time. Otherwise, they have submitted the build material. It's going to be a mainly metal building with a red roof and a red brick material on the front or east facing side of the property, which faces Industrial Drive. Applicant still does need to receive engineering approval. We're waiting for that to be done, but there is a picture in your packet that kind of shows the overall look and feel that the building is going to be when constructed. Are there any specific questions? The applicant did receive the executive summary, and we have not, in the, again, Wayne Muck is acting as agent, is working through those conditions of approval right now. There is a subsequent developer's agreement that will be brought forward to the Common Council at a future meeting. I believe the applicant is hoping to start construction sometime in May this year.
Anybody have any questions or comments? So the Brennan, just as I page down here, there's a picture of that building that you're suggesting. That's just another
building. That is a similar building material and colors that will be that the applicant is going to be utilizing. At the time when I created the packet, we didn't have the material board yet.
Sure.
The only difference between what is in the picture and what the applicant is proposing is they're going to use a brick material in lieu of the stacked stone that you see on that picture. Otherwise, the applicant is looking to propose a red roof and then also the tan siding as proposed on that picture.
Okay. And are there, to help me out here, I'm not very good at reading these things, but are there separate elevations for it, like this picture actually shows, or not? So, I mean, the front part of the building?
The front part of the building is the east elevation that faces Industrial Drive, and that will be a lower portion, office space, about 625 square feet. So it's very similar, I think, to the building that you see in front of you. Think of it basically as if you were driving down Industrial Drive, that would be kind of the look that you would see. Very okay. similar to that.
Okay. All right. Wayne, hi. How are you? Is there anything that you wanted to add to what Brennan has said at all?
Pretty much covered it. Like you were saying, the actual building, the photograph shows the concept that we're trying to achieve. The roof pitch on the actual main part of the building, the shop part, would be a lower roof pitch than the pictures in the office.
Okay. And I know that you're the builder here, but as far as the executive summary and the recommendations, have you had a chance to look at those, and do those fit with what you guys are planning to do?
Right.
They do? Yeah. Okay. All right. Awesome. Any other questions? Discussion? So planning approves the
correct.
Site plan.
That is correct.
Okay. So if you make a motion to approve this, where this is the final spot right here, it doesn't move on.
I move to approve.
Okay. I'll second.
Motion by Allen, second by Tracy, that we approve of the site plan review for Kenny Tijinsky's property in South Industrial Drive. Discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Against? Motion carried. Allen. Second by Tracy. You're not old enough to forget that fast. All right. Good luck, Wayne. Thanks.
Thank you.
All right. I think we're down to zoning code rewrite update.
Yep. Just an announcement that the second community chat will be occurring on Tuesday, April 23rd from 6 to 8 p.m. here at the lower level library meeting rooms. We are working in conjunction with the library exhibit that evening. There will be the community chat is going to be an update of where we are currently from the first community chat that occurred in January, along with we will have some small group roundtable exercises to start looking at the bulk requirements for, you know, the proposed zoning code districts, the look and feel. So again, looking at the kind of design standards, build materials, everything else. So East Central Wisconsin Regional Plan Commission will be facilitating that meeting, and then several members of staff will be there that night as well. That's really what I have for the update for the zoning code rewrite. It's just an announcement to anyone that is interested to attend that community chat on the 23rd.
All right. And then under reports?
In your packet, you do have the March building and code enforcement reports. We're definitely seeing a strong surge as the spring snow has melted, and a lot of people are coming in for spring and summer projects. A lot of remodeling going on, a bunch of sheds and decks being proposed, siding, roofing. So that is a positive. And then with the snow melting, we're starting to see all the winter blues of code enforcement as well. So Elizabeth is back out and handling some of those enforcement issues as well. As for development updates, I think Tracy's the only one that has or has not heard. I did submit my resignation, so this may or may not be my last Plan Commission meeting, depending on the transition plan that I'm working with Henry and the city on right now. So it's been a pleasure serving the Plan Commission for the last five, almost 6 years. You guys will have some exciting projects coming forward here in the next couple months, so that'll you guys should be looking forward to that.
All right. Any questions, comments? I think anything for the good of the meeting? Looking for a motion to adjourn then.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Alan, second by Eric, that we adjourn. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Against? Motion carried. We are adjourned at 5:30 p.m. Have a great night, everybody.